Good morning, and let us begin our topic. In the previous topic, we read to fill the relative clauses in blank spaces. Today, we will study how to combine two sentences in a relative pronoun. So, today our topic is connecting two sentences using relative pronouns. Relative pronouns are words used to combine two clauses into one. Relative pronouns are words used to combine two clauses into one. Besides combining the two clauses, the relative pronoun acts as the subject or object of the verb in the relative clause. Listen, relative pronouns are words used to combine two clauses into one. Besides combining the two clauses, the relative pronoun acts as the subject or object of the verb in the relative clause. It also serves as a conjunction connecting the two clauses. It also serves as a conjunction connecting the two clauses. Let us start first. The use of who or that in defining clause. So, who is the subject of relative clause? Here, who is the subject of relative clause? Example, the woman is a doctor. The woman is a doctor. She lives next door. Our first sentence is, the woman is a doctor. And the second sentence is, she lives next door. So, in both these sentences, the second sentence is about the subject of the first sentence. In both these sentences, the second sentence is about the subject of the first sentence. So, who is the subject of relative clause? Example, the woman is a doctor. She lives next door. So, in these two sentences, listen. In these two sentences, the second sentence, she lives next door, is about the subject, the woman, of first sentence. Listen, in these two sentences, the second sentence, she lives next door, is about the subject, the woman, of the first sentence. When these sentences are written together, listen, when these sentences are written together, when these sentences are written together, the next door will be written, the next door will be written just after the woman. Listen. The woman is a doctor. Second sentence, she lives next door. So, in these two sentences, the second sentence, she lives next door, is about the subject, the woman, of the first sentence. When these two sentences are written together, the next door will be written just after the woman by adding who. So, the sentence will be, the woman who lives next door is a doctor. Now here, the woman and she. Listen. Here, the woman and she are used for the same person. Here, the woman and she are used for the same person, and she is the subject of second sentence. So here, a suitable relative pronoun who will be installed or used, and a relative clause will be made. Example, the woman who lives next door is a doctor. So here the woman and she are used for the same person, and she is the subject of second sentence. So here a suitable pronoun who will be installed or at or used, and a relative pronoun clause will be made. The woman who lives next door is a doctor. We can use that in place of who or whom or which in defining clause. So the sentence will be, the woman that lives next door is a doctor. So the use of who or that in defining clause. First sentence, the woman is a doctor. Second, she lives next door. In both these sentences, the second sentence is about the subject of the first sentence. So the woman who lives next door is a doctor. The woman that lives next door is a doctor. Our second use, the use of whom, who, that in defining clause. So the use of whom, who, or that. Whom can be used as an object of relative clauses. Whom can be used as an object of relative clauses. It is also possible to use who instead of it. It is also possible to use who instead of it. In some circumstances, we can use that also. Example. First, the woman was on holiday. Second, I want to see her. The woman, I want to see her, was on holiday. So, two sentences, the woman was on holiday, I want to see her. So, here we will use whom, who, and that. In these two sentences, I want to see her is telling something about the woman of the first sentence. Listen. In these two sentences, the second sentence, I want to see her, is telling something about the woman of the first sentence. Her of the second sentence is an object, and this word is used for the woman. Listen, her of the second sentence is an object, and this word is used for the woman. Her will be removed or deleted, and whom will be written just after the woman. Listen, here we will remove or delete her and write whom just after the woman. So the sentence will be, the woman whom I want to see was on holiday. The woman whom I want to see was on holiday. We can use who or that in place of whom and can leave relative pronoun. So the woman who I want to see was on holiday. The woman that I want to see was on holiday. So for the use of whom, who, or that in defining clause, we can use whom, who or that. Whom can be used as an object of relative clause, and it is also possible to use who or that instead of whom. So here is the example, the woman was on holiday. Second, I want to see her. The woman whom I want to see was on holiday. The woman who I want to see was on holiday. The woman that I want to see was on holiday. So the woman I want to see her, we will change this one, this statement, this word, these words by using whom, who or that. So the woman whom I want to see was on holiday. The woman who I want to see was on holiday. The woman that I want to see was on holiday. So we can use who or that in place of whom and can leave relative clause over here. Our next is the use of which. The use of which or that. We are discussing about the defining clauses. So, the use of which and that. Which or that is used as defining relative pronoun for objects and animals. Which or that is used for defining relative pronouns for objects and animals. It can be used for both the subject or object of a relative clause also. Listen, it can be used for both the subject or object of a relative clause. The dog was black. Full stop. Second sentence, you bought it. First, the dog was black. Second, you bought it. So, the dog which or that you bought was black. So, which or that? The dog is an object. And when which or that is used for an object, then we can remove which or that also. The dog you bought was black. Listen. The dog was black. Full stop. Second sentence, you bought it. In these two sentences, which or that? Which or that? We will use and the dog is an object. So the sentence will the dog which you bought was black. The dog that you bought was black. When which or that is used for an object, then we can remove which or that. The dog you bought was black. So, in these two forms, we can combine these two sentences. The dog was black, you bought it. The dog which or that you bought was black. The dog you bought was black. Our next use is related to the position of preposition in relative clauses. Position of preposition in relative clauses. When a preposition is given to the object of the subordinate clause, listen, when a preposition is given to the object of the subordinate clause, it is either placed immediately before the relative pronoun. Listen, it is either placed immediately after the relative pronoun and the object is removed, or the preposition is allowed to remain its place and we remove the object. Listen, it is either placed immediately after the relative pronoun and the object is removed, or the preposition is allowed to remain in its place and we remove the object. In such a sentence, it is advisable to use that. We can use that in such type of sentences. Let us see the example. The forest was full of wild animals. Full stop. Second sentence, they went through it. So, the forest was full of wild animals. Second, they went through it. The forest through which they went was full of wild animals. The forest through which they went was full of wild animals. The forest that they went through was full of wild animals. The forest that they went through was full of wild animals. Next use, the use of whose or of which. Whose, of whose or of which. Whose or of which are those relative pronouns that are used to describe a possession. Listen, these two, whose or of which are those relative pronouns that are used to describe a possession. Whose is used with person and of which is used with lifeless thing or animals. Listen, whose is used with person and of which is used with lifeless things or animals. Let us see example. This is the boy. Full stop. Second sentence, his father teaches you English. This is the boy. Full stop. His father teaches you English. So, his of second sentence is a possessive adjective referring to the first sentence. Listen, his of second sentence is a possessive adjective referring to the first sentence. So, whose will be used to describe the complete sentence. This is the boy whose father teaches you English. This is the boy whose father teaches you English. So, in the first sentence, his of second sentence is a possessive adjective referring to the first sentence. So, we will use whose. To combine this sentence, this is the boy whose father teaches you English. Second, this is the car. This is the car. Its parts are not available now. This is the car. Full stop. Its parts are not available now. So, this is the car of which, parts are not available now. So, in second sentence, its is a possessive adjective and is used for the car. Because car is a lifeless and we will use relative pronoun of which. We have already read here that whose or of which are those relative pronouns that are used to describe a possession. Whose is for living or with persons and of which is for lifeless. So here his is for the boy and its is for the car. So, in first sentence we will use whose and in second sentence we will use of which. So, First sentence, this is the boy, full stop. Its second sentence, his father teaches you English. This is the boy whose father teaches you English. Second sentence, this is the car, full stop. Its parts are not available now, full stop. This is the car of which parts are not available now. So let us see next use. And the next is use of when, where, what, why. When is used in a sentence having at which time or at or during the time, that or after, just after which. If the sentence has antecedent time, then when is used after it. When the sentence has antecedent time, then when is used after it. Example, it was Sunday when we went on a picnic. So it was Sunday when we went on a picnic. In this sentence, Sunday has been used as an antecedent, which are the words of time. Which are the words of time. So we will use when after it. So it was Sunday when we went on a picnic. Second, where is used to show the meaning of the place at, in, to which, the place or situation in which. If the antecedent is related to place, then we use where. Here, if it is related to time, we use when. And second, if the antecedent is related to place, we use where. Example, this is the school where I read for 5 years. This is the school where I read for 5 years. Next, what. What is used for unknown objects or events. What is used for unknown objects or events. There is no antecedent in the sentence. The meaning of it is that which or the things which. Listen, the meaning of it is that which or the things which. They are used in both nominative case or objective case. They are both used in nominative case or objective case. Example, what he says is true. Do what I say. Next, why. Why is used for reason. Why is used for reason. Example, this is the reason why I called you. This is the reason why I called you. So we have read some uses of relative pronouns in defining clauses. Let us move some non-defining. Use of who, whom, whose, which, where in non-defining sentences. First, John's mother, comma, who lives in London, comma, has 3 grandchildren. Full stop. He gave me the letter, comma, which was in a blue envelope. He gave me the letter, comma, which was in a blue envelope. He gave me the letter, comma, which I read immediately. So the use of who, whom, whose, which, where in non-defining clauses are: John's mother, comma, who lives in London, comma, has 3 grandchildren. He gave me the letter, comma, which was in a blue envelope. He gave me the letter, comma, which I read immediately. So today we have read about the connecting two sentences using relative pronouns in defining and non-defining clauses. So do practice of all these uses of relative clauses to combine two sentences using a relative pronoun yourself. Thanks a lot.